This is DHG playing Hellblade, Senua's Sacrifice, as part of Halloween Horror Month.
Say that Odin is always in search of knowledge and wisdom and magic. There was a very wise being named Mimir who guarded the waters of wisdom which flow from the roots of the world tree. Odin wished to drink from this spring, but he had to pay a price. So he gouged out his own eye as offering to Mimir. He drank from the well and traded one way of seeing for another. Hides the path to Valravn. Don't trust your eyes. Find another way to see the truth.
Behind the veil, don't we? Once we do, we mostly just close our eyes again and pretend what we saw was never really there.
Put up the illusion. Obfuscate what is really there.
I
Oh, it just opens. I was overthinking it.
This is the price she pays for seeing things differently. Because once you gaze into the relentless darkness, all that lurks within it can see you too.
All that stuff floating around on screen kind of makes it look like I'm in the animus.
The Northmen will not stop her. She will find what she's looking for.
Comes from ravens, allowing the ravens to break his magic seal.
Show me what you have seen, Truth. Look how much it's changed. To another world that looks the same but feels different. An imposter world where the forest itself is watching. Another gate.
Another gate. You know
ravens. Journeyed into the wilds of her native land, living off berries, roots, and rabbits. It's not uncommon, you see. We call such a person a gelt. Some, like Truth, become gelt in search of penance. Others, like Senua, to purge a curse. Those who make it back.
It's a trick.
She's doing it on her own. He's not tricking her. It's magic.
It's an illusion. Simple. The worst kind comes without warning. Deep and primal signal from within. A reminder that just because you cannot see the threat, it doesn't mean that it's not.
You
time to do some damage.
Sons and grandsons were dark after him. Of his daughters and granddaughters, some were monsters, but others fair. But there was another who came from the ice. Buri. In shape, he was like a man, big and powerful. His son, Bor, took a fair giant to be his wife, and they had three sons. Odin was the eldest, and the Northmen hold him to be the foremost of the gods. The old father.
Do you know what it's like to leave everything behind? Your home, loved ones, to head deep into the wilds, perhaps never to return. Senua does. Because when darkness speaks, it changes everything. Turning home into a foreign land and loved ones into strangers. Exile makes sense when you realize that you were never really home in the first place. This reminds her of someone. The forest.
Where? Which forest?
Forest in the wilds.
The wilds.
She left the room.
She went to the wilds a long time ago.
But how did she go to the wilds?
She wanted to fight her own darkness. She thought she could beat her own.
Did she beat her darkness?
No. It nearly killed her, but she tried.
Druth helped her.
If it wasn't for Druth, she'd be dead.
She can't beat her own darkness. She wanted to marry Dillian.
She came to the world.
But she didn't.
She thought her curse would affect him.
She thought her curse would spread to him. She thought she'd bring the darkness to him too. She nearly died.
She thought the curse made her tainted.
Druth helped her.
Hmm.
Oh, that wasn't here before. I think these are pointing out the way to go.
In the wilds, in the cold winter woods. She no longer felt fit for this world. She almost gave in to the darkness. But she remembered Dillian's words. She remembered her promise. She resolved to fight on and kill that which had become.
Northmen say you must sacrifice in order to receive. They tell either runes were revealed to Odin only in sacrifice. He hung himself from the world tree, and he stabbed himself with a spear, and he dedicated a sacrifice to himself. For 9 nights he hung on the tree without food or drink, and at last he saw the runes below him. He gave a cry, and gathered them in his mind and learned them. Then he fell from the tree.
Thank you.
ravens.
They've all gone.
No.
There's three.
Where have
they gone?
She did it with us.
Looking back, I was so naive to think she could banish it on her own. The further she saw into the darkness, the more she struggled to see anything at all. And the glow. The smallest hints of shape, sound, thought, grew in strength until they consumed her whole. Before she knew it, the darkness had her in its claws.
That won't work. Bull Raven's pointing this way. That ain't it. It sounds like the voices are saying right. Now they're laughing. Yes. That's nothing.
Such thing as victory when it comes to the darkness. It's like it doesn't want to kill us. Yet, your lord, biding its time. Only when she is at her weakest will it strike to kill. Will she find Dillian before her time comes?